right now we have gridlock in Washington and nothing's getting done.
Christie Vilsack says she's the candidate voters should send to Washington. Vilsack is a familiar face to most Iowans.
She traveled the state as First Lady of Iowa for 8 years when her husband Tom was elected to the office in 1998. Well, now she's running against incumbent Congressman Steve King in Iowa's new 4th District. Last night, we heard from him. Tonight, Stacey Horse profiles Christie Vilsack.
I've been a small-town person my whole life. I've taught in rural schools my whole life. I have lived in small towns my whole life. That's what my whole campaign is about.
62-year-old Vilsack was born and raised in Mount Pleasant in southeast Iowa. She worked decades as a teacher in rural schools and was a working journalist for the Mount Pleasant News. As First Lady of Iowa, she promoted education and literacy programs across the state. Then came the opportunity to work with the nonprofit Iowa Initiative.
After I finished being First Lady for 8 years, I had the opportunity to work with the Iowa Initiative, which is a 5-year research program, which is looking for to create a national model for how we reduce the number of unintended pregnancies among adult women 18 to 30.
Vilsack served as executive director of the Iowa Initiative for more than 3 years, stepping away to run for office. The results of the initiative have Vilsack beaming.
And I'm really proud of this because we in Iowa have shown that by providing access to low-cost contraceptives, that we've reduced the number of unintended pregnancies in Iowa by 8% and the abortion rate by 26%.
Before entering the race, Vilsack crisscrossed the newly drawn 4th District on a listening tour, talking directly to the Iowans she would represent as the first congresswoman from our state.
It's all about people and it's about their families and what they want their communities to look like 10, 20 years from now.
Teachers.
Vilsack says representing the 4th Congressional District is all about creating economic opportunity at the local level, connecting each community to the resources they need, maximizing their potential.
For me, it's about making sure that people can continue to live in small towns and work and raise their families there and find a good job and a meaningful job. And in order to do that, we have to continue to build and rebuild the middle class in these small communities and small cities. And so I want to dedicate the next part of my life to making sure we can do that.
That was Stacey Horse reporting for us. Tomorrow, our commitment coverage continues. Hear what Steve King says is his top priority if he is reelected.